All right, today's KCRA3 Kitchen, it's getting hot in here. Chef Athena Palombi joined us this morning. We're making Atyam butternut squash and portobello mushroom crostinis this morning. Atyam.
Atyam.
Instead of autumn.
Perfect for your fall
It all
party.
Works. It all works. And you know what's great, Athena, is that butternut squash is everywhere right now. And a lot of people are just pulling it out of their local gardens, too.
Absolutely. And we have so many wonderful farmers markets here in Sacramento to pull from. Yeah. And this is a great way to do a creative play on using butternut squash.
All right. Well, let's get started.
I just love it. So right here, we have just thrown in our butternut squash, some portobello mushrooms. We have some onions, some garlic, and we put canola and olive oil in there to make sure that the olive oil doesn't burn and create the mixture to be bitter.
So canola oil will help olive oil not burn?
Yes, actually, it has a higher flash point, and so it helps to conduct heat better in a pan. So
like a little science lesson. Did you cook the squash before you put it in there, or did you put it in there raw?
No, I put it all in there raw. We just cut it in there and put it in raw, and we just sauteed everything until everything just kind of started
That's perfect. I guess you could roast it ahead of time if you really wanted to.
If you really wanted to, the only thing that you really need to make sure of is that you don't get it too soft, because once you apply these to the crostinis and put them on top, you're going to put them into the oven another time to melt the fontina cheese that's going to go on.
All right, let's keep moving here.
Let's make it happen.
So this is a really creative way to do a crostini. Typically, you would do like just a baguette slice. But what we did is we took sliced French bread and we just took a little cookie cutter, and then you're just going to go around the edges here.
And you have a little apple cookie cutter.
We have a little apple one. We've done some pumpkin ones, and we have some autumn leaves. So those are all in different shapes.
It's a little autumn leaf. You can't really close up on that, but it's so cute. And
they're so
cheesy.
All right, and they're perfect for any party, and the kids love them too. They just think they're the cutest. So we have our little apple right here, and we're just going to take a little bit of olive oil and canola oil again, and we're going to take our pastry brush, and we're going to brush this on both sides. And we've got that already sauteed. I actually scooted that off the burner there because
I heard it sizzling on one side.
It was sizzling and sizzling. So all you do is you just place this straight into the pan, just like this, and just let it toast just like this on both sides. And then we're going to just take a little bit of the mixture here, just a very little bit, and make sure we get a mushroom on there. Fabulous. And then we have some wonderful fontina cheese over here. And this is a great Italian cheese that comes from...
I'm going to get these out of the way so we can see it a little bit better.
So we can see it, yes.
There you go.
This is a great Italian cheese, and it's from the Alps in northern Italy. And we're just going to put a little bit of this right on the top there. And it's
running out of time.
And you can, of course, see that recipe for butternut squash.
Yes.
You will find it at kcra.com/mornings.
Thank you, Athena.
Thank you so much, girls.